Greetings, fellow Earthlings. Welcome back to some more Elder Scrolls Arena. Last time we left off, we were at the second floor of Black Gates, one of those, huge dungeons that we have to raid in order to raid another huge dungeon. But the second one actually matters, this one doesn't. Anyway, so the last time we left off, this is actually a puzzle door. We were faced by this puzzle door. The answer to this, I actually sat back and thought about the answer to this for a long time and I couldn't find anything. So the only answer I could find on the internet was rain. Now I have got no idea how rain comes in sheets. I mean, you could say that it creates heat. No, it doesn't make sense even that way. I mean, I was about to say, you could say that it comes in sheets, it forms sheets, but that's what snow does. I don't know how rain comes in sheets, but anyway, the answer is rain. So here we go. And the door is now unlocked. Let me just go ahead and update the save here. And we shall continue our exploration of this area. Huh, human bones. That's always an encouraging sight. Troll is regenerating. Good to know. Does this door open? Yes, it does. So, interesting indeed. It looks like a huge mess of a place. An iron door. Shit. Sometimes the speed with which these guys come over is, shocking to say the least. But oh well, it is what it is. I mean, damn. Did you, like, see that guy stride out of the darkness into me? That was like a jump scare. Anyway, moving further onwards. Hey, what is this? It's a skeleton with a sword stuck inside of it. How interesting. How interesting indeed. One of the weirder things about this game is how the sprites have got like just one skin, like one or two skins, and yeah, they will change angles depending on where you're looking at them from. So if I look at it from here, the skeleton lies like this, but you go over here and you turn back and voila, it turns out the skeleton is actually alive. Let's just hope it doesn't come back to bite us in the ass. Another ghost here, another troll, another iron door. I didn't hear you approach me this time around. Just a buckler, nothing more. Let me just go ahead and save the game again. Just in case, you know. Ah, some treasure. Amazing. 20 gold pieces. Can I carry this stuff? No, I cannot. Yeah, I know you came back up from sleep. I put you to sleep, but you rose back up. Like the Undertaker. The Ring of Healing. It doesn't heal you much, but at least it heals you, so, and I guess that's what matters in the end. Let me just update the save here and check where we are at the map. Seems like a pretty... Now this might be one of those ditch areas, you know, the areas where there's a ditch in the middle of the room, but hey, there was a door there. I completely missed that. I guess we'll have to go back to that side. Or is this like a connecting passageway? Yes, it is. Interesting. Quite interesting. Very interesting to know. So this area has nothing in it? I guess not. And this, I think this looks like a tunnel of sorts, so we might have to enter it sooner or later in the course of the game. Zombie is nothing usable, okay. Is there anything else to this room? Just this? A fancy curve to the wall here. And I could hear a ghost, but I don't really know where the ghost is or where it was. So I guess we're only left with the third door now. I can see some water in this level, so maybe that might have some clue as to where we need to go or don't go. We could roam around on over on this side, but let's just clear this area first. I don't know, I mean, it seems that we are near the edge of the map here, so might as well, right? Anyway, let me just go ahead and update the save again, in case I die. Another skeleton with a sword stuck in its heart. 80 gold pieces, amazing, that calls for another save. I mean, why not? It's 80 gold pieces. Might as well, right? Hey, wait, what is this? Is this like a hidden door or something? No, it isn't. It isn't a hidden door. Three doors in quick succession. And a door opposite this. Very interesting. Interesting indeed. A human loot. Too bad I can't carry any of the other things there. So. I know I've been taking it quite slow with the series, and to be entirely honest, I mean, I haven't really been having much time to do anything. So, yeah, I hope you guys can forgive me if I'm being too slow with the series. Not that, you know, any of you guys are probably watching, but yeah. For future viewers, if you've got a problem with this, I deeply apologize. I'm just at a crossroads, I'm jobless, I just got out of college, and yeah, I'm hunting for jobs, picking up my skills, while trying to make a YouTube career for myself, all at the same time, so yeah, it's been a little rough for me. Let's check this area out first. It's most probably nothing, but you never know, right? Wait, are we going the right way? Yes, we are. That's the way we came from. Saving for the sake of saving. Because you never know when the game can end in like a fraction of a second. I can hear ghosts, but I have got no clue where they are. So, there's a river here, there's a path which leads underneath. There's a whole entire unexplored section over here. Interesting. Let's clear this side of the river first, I guess. I mean, probably should. I correct myself, there isn't anything here either. Except for what seems to be tunnels. Interesting, I guess. Do we want to take a dunk inside the river? Might as well, right? I'm just gonna save in the middle of nowhere and go for a swim. Hopefully it'll be difficult for people to hit us when we're under here. I like what I'm hearing. Oh, it's a magically held lock. Okay, is this the objective? It might be. And I think I can hear what is an iron golem, an iron centurion sort of thing, so quite interesting to say the least. Maybe we can go through it from under here. Let's try this. I mean, it is a magically held lock, so I'll just take a moment to update the save again. And there seems to be nothing on the opposite side of it. Yeah, there isn't, except for this tunnel here, which doesn't really go anywhere. And we take a swim. Ah, I stand corrected. There is nothing here. Except for this unique little room, and there's the iron golem that we were jamming to all this while. Potion of Yield True, thank you. And the sooner you die, the sooner I can proceed with my life. I found a sapphire key. Now, is that the key that I want? That's a real question, isn't it? I'm just gonna use a ring of healing here and update the save. there seem to be more of these guys here. And this seems to be yet another door. Oh, I could open this one. That's nice, I guess. So what was the other door for? Is this like an iron golem which gives me nothing? Okay, fine, I can... I think I can make do with that. Let me just update the save here. That was the sound of the door closing. Nothing else here. Seems to be nothing. Oh shit! I totally was not expecting this guy to be here. And he just vanishes off into the air. Is this the hammer that we were looking for? I guess it is. Amazing. You have found the legendary hammer of Gharen. Once it is united with its mate, the anvil of Mithas in the palace of Ebonheart, it will ring with the location of the secret entrance to Dagoth-Ur. So wait, how does this work? You strike the hammer onto the anvil and it makes a resonating sound which, you know, hums the tune of the location of Dagoth-Ur. Does it like go like a sonorous hum with here lies Dagoth-Ur or something like that? I mean, I know that was a horrible impersonation, but you get the point, don't you? Just gonna update my dungeon escape save and heal here, and this turned out to be a pretty short stream. Sorry guys. I mean, I think I could stay for a bit and... Now, where did I come from? Interesting. I think I... yeah. I have to go all the way here. And then take this door and... yeah, well, we still have to escape this place, so that's another thing entirely, but... as far as things go, I think we have pretty much completed this level for what it is. Escaping. Always a pain in the buttocks. Why am I even swimming? Why am I wasting my stamina when I can just walk on land? I'm not Jesus, I can't walk on water, but I sure can walk on land. This seems to be a shortcut. Do we want to take this route? Do we? How much gold do we have? Plenty-ish. I do need a few more potions. Hey, my stats are all back to normal. Or so it would seem. I can appreciate that. Thank you very much. This game can be buggy sometimes, but sometimes it's like amazing, so yeah. I guess we'll just go with the devil we know, rather than the devil we don't. The troll is regenerating. Where is the troll? Bye bye, see you later. Let me just confirm whether I have it or not. Am I disturbing you? I hope not. So this cat that... yeah, I have that. I have the Hammer of Gharen. So, I have this cat that has been sitting outside of my... seriously, welcome with the fireball. Oh yeah, I forgot. I still have to fight off the Medusas, don't I? Good thing I saved the game where I did. Oh, sorry, it was a lightning bolt, not a fireball. Okay, hold up. Take it easy there. That was making quick work of him, I suppose. Heal true, potion of resist shock, I think. I mean, I do have to buy some potions. Where are you attacking from is what I want to know. Hold up, man. Come on, let me heal up first. Yeah, I think I'll need another potion of resist shock. And another potion of heal true. As I have said before, half this game is pausing the game to open your inventory and half of it is opening your own damn map. This is what the game is. Deal with it. Okay, so in a bit we're gonna have to face some Medusas right here, I suppose. Yep. But hey, at least they aren't using the ranged paralyzed attacks, so that is something good, I would say. But they really do take away a lot of your health just by existing. Just by, you know, striking you when they do. Plate Cuirass. I'm tempted to discard something to pick that up. So where do we go from here? We keep going straight and... we keep going south, then we take an east, then another east, then we swim across the river. Back home. We take the river all the way back to this point here, and then we make our way back home. Okay, the escape path isn't terribly short, but it isn't terribly long either, so yeah, I'm just gonna save the game here. And onwards unto... what? Oh, it was a secret door. A good thing about these ranged enemies is that when they get stuck in walls like that, yeah, they can't hit you for obvious reasons, but it still is a good habit to save every time you meet one of those fuckers. Because you have literally no idea when you might come across them again. And I guess this would not be a bad juncture for me to use a potion of levitation. I think I've got a lot of them. Wingardium Leviosa on myself. I can hear some ghosts. And where are we right now? We need to be here at the crossroads, and then we take an upward turn. And we really do not want to engage any ghosts along the way. Or any hellhounds for that matter. Because they suck! I sometimes forget how fast it is to travel in this game. Are we there yet? Yes, we are. So, now we can take... we've got two choices. We can either go through here, or we can just go through here. I guess we'll just take this way. It's broader. Again, time for another save. And yeah, as soon as you can step off of it. Just the people that I did not want to see. Wraiths. I hope I am attacking you. One of the things which I don't like about these wraiths is how they just disappear. They don't even give you anything for all the troubles that you went through. They're like, yeah, cool. I attacked you, but I guess, you know, you don't really need it. I'm just gonna leave. Not unlike what I do, you know? I attack them and I leave. The cat's looking super cute right now. Just a moment, let me just click a picture. I think I was about to use a ring of healing and some potions of resist shock. And save the game, I suppose. Oh, cool. Not too much of a hassle, but I did hear a door closing, and I don't really know what that was about. And I think I am disturbing the cat, because she's being quite shifty in her sleep. I will just update the savior. Skeevers. Actually, the correct term would be rats. As far as this game is concerned, anyway. Okay, so where do we want to go again? I think we need to head back to Mournhold? No, it was Ebonheart. Ebonheart it is. I'm saying that right. You enter King Cassik's audience chamber, shaking the chill of the grey autumn day from your skin. Being currently at peace with its neighbor Mournhold, the leading citizens of Ebonheart have met to discuss the resultant implications with their king. I see, you're at war with Mournhold. Do I want to save right now? Doesn't hurt, I guess, does it? It's a good thing I can save inside palaces. Is this the screenshot? I guess it is. Yeah. works. Or perhaps a little farther back. Yeah, this works. Or even this works. Yeah. Anyway, well done, Grimfangs. You have done the realm a service it will not easily forget. Smiths across the land will hail your arrival. Good, they should. I've been busting my ass up for a lot. Now, for my part of the bargain, King Cassik rings the hammer of Gharen onto the anvil. Listening intently, a slow smile spreads across his features. Gesturing to you, he inscribes the location of the entrance to Dagoth-Ur, somewhere in the northern part of Morrowind, onto your map. Thank you very much, Your Highness, Sire, or whatever else you would like to be addressed as. That was an unexpectedly short read, but I suppose I will end this stream and this video right here, right now. And yeah, I guess I'll just be back today itself to record at least the first floor of Dagoth-Ur. So